What do a murder-for-hire plot, a former presidential candidate, and an exotic animal park have in common? A man called Joe Exotic. Joe Maldonado-Passage, better known as Joe Exotic, is a man with a colorful past, to say the least. He's a self-proclaimed country music artist, the former owner of an exotic animal park, a one-time candidate for governor of Oklahoma, and he even ran for president in 2016. His life is anything but tame.
I have a judgment against me from some bitch down there in Florida, but I can tell you I paid a fine with the USDA, and that is nothing but a civil fine, ladies and gentlemen. That does not mean that I was accused or convicted of any kind of animal cruelty thing.
Joe Exotic was the owner of the GW Exotic Animal Park in Oklahoma. Animal rights groups often condemned his controversial business practices. He faced multiple citations from the USDA and even underwent a federal investigation after a tiger attacked an employee. Carole Baskin, the CEO of Florida wildlife sanctuary Big Cat Rescue, was arguably one of his biggest critics, and their contentious relationship may have been what led to his arrest.
He's made mannequins with her likeness and blown them up, shot them. There's probably not a person in leather who came to the park who he didn't solicit to hurt this woman.
I've dealt with so many of these threats from so many of these people that are exploiting animals that, you know, if they treat animals that badly, they have no concern for life.
Joe Exotic's life has repeatedly been in the public eye. In 2017, his husband, Travis Maldonado, accidentally shot himself in a tragic fatal accident.
911.
Yes, I need an ambulance to the GW Exotic Animal Park now.
The witnesses of the staff that was in office when he shot himself, that he thought the gun wouldn't go off without the clip in it.
And according to the Justice Department's timeline, at the same time Joe was trying to hire someone for murder, he was also campaigning for Oklahoma governor.
I came across that you did a music video called Pretty Woman Lover.
Yes, ma'am.
You're dancing in between two scantily clad women. You have your own line of condoms called Tiger King.
Yes.
So who is Joseph Maldonado?
Well, I'm one of the normal people walking around here that actually work for a living instead of sitting in an office or born into politics or bought into politics. And, you know, in order to solve some of the issues out here, you have to live them.
Joe Exotic faces two counts of hiring a person to commit murder. According to court documents, in one instance, he gave an unnamed person $3,000 to travel from Oklahoma to South Carolina, then on to Florida to kill Jane Doe.
If I wanted to kill her, I would have done it way before I spent $750,000 arguing with her in court to hire a $3,000 hitman. Now, how much sense does that make?
The second count cites that Joe asked a different unnamed person to find someone to commit the murder. This person put Joe in contact with an undercover FBI agent. The two met in December of 2017 to discuss the details of the hit, leading to his eventual arrest.
I've been set up, I've been thrown in jail, I've had my rights taken away from me, and I still live in this country where I'm supposed to be innocent until proven guilty.
The new owners of the exotic park say they assisted authorities too.
We just helped the authorities tie some loose ends together.
We are planning to open up a different facility. This place is very tainted by Joe's name, and we do not want to be associated with it.
My attorney probably doesn't want me talking about my case, but I can tell you that the bastard that's given my stuff away is the one who set me up so I could get put in jail and he could get away with this.
So you were set up?
You bet your ass. I've got so much evidence on this man, and the U.S. Attorney's Office seems like they could give a shit less. My husband tried to go remove my animals. He threatened to shoot anybody that entered the property. And my mom still owns half the land, keep in mind. They demolished my house with all of my personal belongings in it. At what point is this man going to go to jail?
Joe Exotic entered a plea of not guilty and will remain in custody until his trial on November 7th, 2018.
They denied me bail, okay? They
Right.
denied me bond because they said that I was suicidal.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't seen a counselor. I haven't seen nobody. And a prosecutor and a judge can just deem me suicidal to keep me in jail so I can spend $700 on a commissary because you have to buy your salt, pepper, ketchup, mayonnaise here? Bull. I am looking forward to the day of proving that I am innocent. I just want my rights as an American citizen under the Constitution to be innocent until proven guilty, and that don't mean lock me up in a 6 by 8 foot cell so I can have to smell 4 other people farting all day. I wouldn't get away with putting a chimpanzee in this situation.
What do you think about the case and the life of Joe Exotic? Let us know in the comments below. I'm Alexandra Stone, and this has been your Weekly Dispatch. Thanks for watching Dispatches from the Middle. If you liked this episode, subscribe for more stories like this.